Jane Fonda, welcome back to the project. It's so lovely to be catching up with you again.
Thank you. It is.
Congratulations on luck. I absolutely loved watching this movie. In many ways, it really puts things into perspective right now. And it really subscribes to that idea that sometimes in life, being unlucky can have its advantages. Is that something that you subscribe to?
Yes, I do. I do. I'm very glad that Babe the dragon was able to be intelligent enough and flexible enough to realize at the end it's not a binary situation where it's all good luck and bad luck is over here and it can't come anywhere or we'll all be destroyed. No, it's the different sides of the same coin. You know, it's like silence makes no sense without noise. Life makes no sense without death. Good luck makes no sense without bad luck. You need the both of them. And as you said, very often it's bad luck. It's the challenges and the traumas of life that can give you strength and teach you lessons. There's an expression that I like a lot. God doesn't come into us through our successes and our awards. God comes into us through our wounds, through our scars, and that's true.
I love that. Of course, you are one of the most successful and hardworking actors on the planet. But looking back, Jane, are there times throughout your life where you look back and you think there was some luck involved in that happening?
Well, yeah, the circumstances of my birth. You know, I was born to a privileged middle-class family. I have white privilege. My father was a famous person. I had nothing to do with that. That was just luck. Now, what I did was I worked very hard to become somebody who could recognize an opportunity that was coming my way and seize it and use it. Luck is opportunity meeting preparation. I was prepared to have good luck come along. And I'm glad that I lived that way and tried.
Have there been times when luck wasn't on your side?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. When I was 20, I was ancient. I was old and depressed, and there was no luck, and I saw no future. And I just assumed that I would never live past 30. I'm almost 85 years old. So, you know, it's very hard to be young. Picasso said, it takes a long time to become young. I didn't start becoming young till I was in my 70s.
Well, you do young so well.
Thank you. Thank
you. She might do young well, but Jane has always been profound. Upon her 40th birthday, she said, "I want to prove that I can flourish in spite of all the controversy. People root for a survivor. Maybe I represent someone who fights back and still survives."
Did I really say that?
Yes, you did.
It was prescient if I said that, because that's exactly what happened. I was not meant to survive. I was not meant to, you know, bounce back. I'm very resilient. Resilience and luck are kind of the same.
They are a bit. Perhaps they go hand in hand. Jane, many of your more recent projects like Luck, like Book Club, like Grace and Frankie, seem to concentrate more on female friendships these days rather than romantic relationships. Do you find that you treasure your female friendships more these days?
It's the most important thing in my life. Women friendships are very different than men friendships. Men friendships are men sitting next to each other looking out, "Oh God, look at that car. Whoa, that car is so slick. Oh my God, look at that woman. Look at the booty on that woman." Blah, 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 you know what I mean? They're looking out and talking about things. Women, now obviously this is a big generalization, but it is generally true. Women sit face to face. They look into each other's eyes. They're not afraid of saying, I'm scared, I need you, I need help. Can you hug me? They're not afraid of crying with each other. And when they laugh together, oh my God. You know, a study was done at Harvard that showed that the lack of women friendship is as bad for your health as smoking. I mean, isn't that something?
Wow.
I don't know what I would do without my women friends. And I make sure to have friends that are younger than me. That's not difficult. Braver than me, who inspire me and put starch in my spine.
Jane, it sounds like a recipe for a happy life. Thank you so much for joining us on the project. It is always such a joy to chat to you. Thanks.
Thank you. Stay safe.
Oh, I just love that woman. Love premieres exclusively on Apple TV Plus this Friday.